Hello all. Okay, let's get into the topic. Am I audible to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Could you be able to see the slides?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the next topic is about the preceding topic. About the lymphatic and immune system vocabulary. So the remaining part about this lymphatic system is, first one is allergen. Allergen means the allergy causing agent. We call it as allergen. We also call it as antigen, because those will cause the harmful effects to our body. For example, allergen will be like food. For some people, the brinjal will be the allergy. For some people, banana. And for some people, certain vegetables, they won't suit to the body. That leads to hypersensitivity reaction, such as inflammation, itching, all those things will be there. For some people, pollen grains are the allergens. For some people, chalk dust. So likewise, and dust allergy, all these things we call it as allergens. Allergens are the substance which causes the allergy. And allergist, the physician who actually specializes in testing for and treating allergies. Okay, what and all the things are allergen to us, and what is the type of allergy we get. Some different types of allergies will be there. For usually for girls, they'll get allergy for nickel. So if the jewelry is made up of nickel, more for most of the girls, so that will bring allergy. So usually they'll go with silver or gold. And what is an allergy is actually hypersensitivity to some common substances like dust, nickel, iron, likewise things. Some metals will not get suit to our body, and some food will not get to suit our body, and some dust particles. And what is autoimmune disease is the disease resulting from the immune system. So this is a disease of immune system actually. So our own antigens. So we have an antigen on our RBC. We have antibodies in our plasma. That both will get fight together. Our own antigens and our own antibodies will fight, will cause an inflammatory reaction. We call that as autoimmune disease. Auto means to same, our own. So which include rheumatoid arthritis. So rheumatoid arthritis is an inflammatory reaction. And systemic lupus erythematosus. So this is also. And coming to the next thing, hives. Hives means appearing of wheals as a part of allergic reaction. If you could see, for some people, they'll have a continuous itching reaction. After continuous itching, you can see some spotted like red color bumps will be there all over the skin. That we call it as hives, which is an allergic reaction. And for some people, their tongue will become very big. For some people, their lips will become very big after eating the brinjal. So, and next, HIV, human immunodeficiency virus, so which usually causes AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So the virus that causes AIDS, we also call this virus as retrovirus because it contains RNA as genetic material. And next, immunocompromised. Immune system that does not function properly. For that person, we call it as immunocompromised person. And we also call that as immunodeficiency disorder. Immunoglobulins, these are the antibodies present in our body. For example, so which assist in protecting the body. Next, immunology, which is a branch of medicine, especially concerned with treating the immune system disorders. Inflammation, tissues response to injury. So we have the redness, pain, swelling, feeling hot to touch. All these things together will be there for the inflammation. And lymphedema, excessive amount of tissue fluid will be there. This due to the blockage of the lymphatic flow. So you can see in elephantiasis, so they'll have the blockage of the tissue fluid because of some obstruction in the lymphatic vessels. So the tissue fluid will stay in the tissues itself. So that leads to enlargement of the part. An opportunistic infection. Infection appearing in immunocompromised person, such as infection appearing in AIDS person. So AIDS people are actually immunocompromised people. If that person got any infection, then we call it as opportunistic infection. Means the bacteria or virus is taking an opportunity to get infect that person. And urticaria, severe itching. associated with hives, we call that as urticaria. So this is actually the inflammation. You can see in this thing, the redness of the limb, and this part, the whole part will become red. And hot to touch, painful, all these things will be there. This is actually, we call it as cellulitis. All over the hand will get inflammation. And allergic reaction, which is anaphylactic shock. Any allergic reaction which leads to life-threatening condition. I mean, sometimes the person will die because of allergy also. That we call it as anaphylactic shock, which usually attacks the circulatory and respiratory problems, causes, which also call it as anaphylaxis. And next, elephantiasis. Inflammation and obstruction of lymphatic vessels, resulting in enlarged tissue due to edema. If you see their hand or leg, that will be very bigger. So that's, it looks like an elephant leg or elephant leg. That's why we call it as elephantiasis. And Hodgkin's disease, which is cancer to the lymphatic cells particularly. And it is more concentrated for the lymphatic nodes. Lymphadenitis, inflammation of lymph nodes. We also commonly call swollen glands. And next, mononucleosis, which is actually the acute viral infection with large number of atypical lymphocytes. And non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, cancer of the lymphatic tissue other than Hodgkin's lymphoma. And AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, which is caused by HIV. So which defect the cell-mediated immunity, nothing but the problem with the T lymphocytes. So the T lymphocytes was attacked by the HIV virus. So that leads to decreases the immunity. Immunocompromising will be there in AIDS. And AIDS-related complex, which is an early stage of AIDS. So the symptoms will be weight loss, fatigue, and anorexia, means loss of hunger or loss of appetite. Graft versus host disease. For example, for some person, the kidney got failed. So they have to get kidney from the donor. So if they got the perfect match kidney and the donated kidney got transplanted into our body, then even though our body is not accepting that kidney because of the immunity issues. So our body is telling that is not our kidney. So it will be rejected by our body. So that we call it as graft versus host disease. And next, Kaposi sarcoma, which is actually skin cancer seen in AIDS patient. So you can see the brownish purple skin lesions will be there. And pneumocystis carinii pneumonia, which is very common in AIDS patient, which is an opportunistic infection, which is pneumonia to the AIDS patient. So Kaposi sarcoma is skin cancer to the AIDS patient. Pneumocystis carinii pneumoniae is the common in the AIDS patient, which is an opportunistic infection. And sarcoidosis, which is an autoimmune disease, which forms the fibrous lesions in multiple organs of the body. And severe combined immunodeficiency syndrome, which is actually the genetic disorder. The baby will born without functioning immune system. So very similar to AIDS. AIDS was developed after the viral attack. But for this, the baby will born without immune system itself. And next, coming to the clinical laboratory test, first is ELISA test. ELISA test was done for the AIDS virus in order to know whether the AIDS virus got infected to the person or not, whether the person is exposed to the virus or not. The positive ELISA test will confine the person was exposed to the AIDS virus, means HIV. Western blot is actually backup for ELISA to confirm whether the person will get AIDS or not. That is Western blot. And next, lymphangiography. Lymphangio means lymphatic vessel. Graphy means taking an X-ray. Taking an X-ray to the lymphatic vessel by injecting a dye. Without injecting the dye, we cannot see the lymphatic vessel. And monospot, which is the test for mononucleosis virus. Scratch test, this is an allergy test to know whether the substance is allergy to the patient or not. So they'll put the allergen on the skin with the needle and they will see whether this person is getting the inflammation or not. If the person is getting the inflammation, then he he is allergy to that particular substance. This is the test. So they'll put with the needle, for example, if the person is allergy to pollen grain, they will put the needle into the pollen grain and they will insert into the body. If the person was positive, then he will get the inflammation like this. So this is the allergy. So the person is allergy to that particular substance, then he will get like this. This we call it a scratch test. And coming to the medical procedures, immunotherapy. The patient receives the immunoglobulins injections or antibodies to treat the disease. So for COVID-19, they usually given the immunoglobulins. The person who already affected with COVID-19 and got recovered, from that person, immunoglobulins will be collected and given to the person who got infected and suffering. Vaccination, we all know. So which is a type of passive acquired immunity. So passively, when the person was exposing to the weakened pathogen, like dead virus, so they will incubate the virus and they will make it killed. So they'll kill the virus and they will inoculate into the body. Then our body will come to know how to fight with that antigen. So that is actually the vaccination. The person will then able to fight off the pathogen if he got exposed it in the future also. For example, the chickenpox or smallpox. We get only once in our lifetime. Later on, we can't get because our body will learn how to fight with the disease. And lymphadenectomy. Lymphadeno means lymphatic gland or lymphatic node. So lymphadenectomy means surgical removal of the lymphatic node to test if there is any cancer or metastasis. Metastasis means spreading the cancer to other regions. Coming to the pharmacology, antihistamine. Antihistamine drugs are particularly given to the allergic reactions. And corticosteroids. If the drug is corticosteroid, that is particularly given to the inflammatory, anti-inflammatory, that is used to treat the autoimmune diseases also, such as rheumatoid arthritis, systemic lupus erythematosus. Next, immunosuppressants. So that will usually block the immune system and prevents the rejection of transplant, like graft versus host disease. And protease inhibitor drugs, which inhibits the protease enzyme that needed the virus to reproduce. So this is usually given for the HIV patients for a daily management drug. Reverse transcriptase inhibitor drugs. So this is also given to the AIDS patient, inhibits reverse transcription. So enzymes needed for viruses to reproduce. Coming to the abbreviations, AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, ARC, AIDS related complex, ELISA, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. GVHD, graft versus host disease, and HG, Hodgkin's disease, and HIV, human immunodeficiency virus, and IG, which means immunoglobulins, we also call it as antibodies, KS, Kaposi sarcoma, which is skin cancer to the AIDS patient, mononucleosis, which is viral infection, and NHL, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, and NK, natural killer cells, PCP, pneumocystis carinii pneumonia. SIDS, severe combined immunodeficiency syndrome. So that's it. Okay. Any doubts related to this immune system? If you are okay with this topic, we'll go to the next topic, cardiovascular system.
Okay, ma'am.
All of you, any doubts in this particular topic?
No, ma'am.
Okay, we'll go to the next topic. So the next topic is cardiovascular system. So in this picture, you are seeing is the heart. So the heart will be in the size of our fist. It is located in the mediastinum, For each and every organ, you'll have the location. For example, if they ask you where the kidneys are, then you have to tell retroperitoneal. If they ask where is the stomach, then that is abdomen. And the lungs are in the pleural cavity, in the chest, in the thoracic region. So likewise, for each and every organ, there is a place. For example, if it is the brain, it is present in the cranial cavity. Likewise. And the heart, the human heart is divided into four chambers, upper two chambers and lower two chambers. This chamber we call it as right atrium, and this chamber we call it as left atrium. And this is right ventricle, left ventricle. Atriums are the smaller chambers, ventricles are the bigger chambers. And this we call it as the wall, which is tricuspid wall. The right side we have the tricuspid wall. Tricuspid wall, which means it has the three lip-like structures. So that's why they call it as tricuspid wall. And the left side we have the bicuspid wall. Bi means two. So it has two lip-like openings. And if you could see, the atrium are the thin chambers and the ventricles are the thicker chambers. And this, to the right atrium, we have the two receiving blood vessels, that is. So this we call it as superior vena cava, and this we call it as inferior vena cava. The bluish color part are the veins, and the red color one are the arteries. So this will bring the blood from all over the body into the right atrium. And from here, we have this thing called pulmonary artery. So this pulmonary artery is actually blue because it carries the deoxygenated blood. I'll explain you clearly into the next slides. And this part we call it as aorta. This is actually arch of aorta. And these are the pulmonary veins. So these are pulmonary veins, and this is pulmonary artery, and this is aorta, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava. Okay. And this is right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle and left ventricle. This side we have the tricuspid wall, and this side we have the bicuspid wall. Okay, let's get into the topic. So the functions of cardiovascular system, it actually will distribute the blood to all over the areas of the body, and it deliver the needed substances to the cells. So the each and every tissue and cell needs oxygen and glucose, triglycerides, proteins, hormones, enzymes, and also it releases some of the waste products also, such as urea, ammonia, and hydrogen ions, bicarbonate ions, all this stuff, carbon dioxide. These things also continuously should be eliminated from the tissues. But these bringing and elimination is done by a medium called blood. That blood has to be supplied through blood vessels. That blood has to be pumped by a single organ, which we call it as heart. So what the motor will do, if we fix a motor, the work of the motor is to send the water to each and every house. So that was the actual work with the motor. So the same thing will be done by the heart. Heart will pump the blood to each and every tissues of our body, and also by removing the waste. Coming to the organs of the cardiovascular system, so we have the heart, arteries, capillaries, and veins. So this is the heart. Heart is located in the mediastinum. And this is the artery. Artery was actually the thicker one. Vein is the thinner one. Always the arteries will carry the blood away from the heart. The veins will carry the blood towards the heart. So whatever the blood, whether it may be oxygenated or deoxygenated, arteries will carry the blood away from the heart. Veins will carry the blood towards the heart. So only one artery will carry the deoxygenated blood, that is pulmonary artery. All the arteries will carry oxygenated blood only. All the veins will carry deoxygenated blood except the one vein, that is pulmonary vein. And these are the capillaries. Capillaries are the very, very smaller blood vessels. Coming to the combining forms, angio. Angio means vessel. For example, angiogram, taking an x-ray of blood vessel. Angiography, the process of taking an x-ray of the blood vessel. And so likewise. And aorta, Iota means iota. I already shown you that bigger iota, that was the thing. Arterio, artery. So that which is the blood vessel which carries the blood away from the heart. Atero means fatty substances. Atrio, which means atrium. Cardio, which means heart. For example, cardiology, study of heart. Corona. Corona is also heart. So coronary vessels means blood vessels which supplies the heart. Heme angio. Heme means blood. Angio means vessel. So blood vessel we call it as heme angio. Phlebo. Phlebo means vein. Veno or phlebo. Both means vein only. Spigmo. Spigmo means pulse. Stetho. Stetho means chest. Thrombo, which is clot. Valvo means wall. Valvulo is wall. And vasculo is blood vessel. Vaso is vessel or duct. Veno is vein. Ventriculo is ventricle. Manometer, instrument to use to measure the pressure. For example, sphygmomanometer, instrument which is used to measure the blood pressure. And OLE means small. So, for example, arteriole means smaller artery. Tension. Tension means pressure. For example, hypertension, increased blood pressure. Hypotension. Could someone please mute it? Okay. ULE means smaller one. So, for example, so venule. Venule means smaller vein. Arteriole means smaller artery. Coming to the anatomy and physiology, the heart will comes under circulatory system or cardiovascular system. So it maintains the distribution of the blood throughout the body. Wherever the thing, if the blood want to go, it has to be pumped up by the heart. It delivers the oxygen, nutrients like glucose, amino acids to each and every cell in our body. And also it picks up the carbon dioxide and other waste products from the cells and deliver it to the lungs. Lungs, liver, kidney for elimination purpose. Lungs will eliminate the carbon dioxide. Liver will actually see the any toxic substances likewise in the blood. Kidneys will filter the blood and unwanted waste materials will be filtered by the kidneys. Coming to the anatomy again. So it is composed of heart and the blood vessels are arteries, capillaries and veins. It was divided into two types of circulation. One is pulmonary circulation and other one is systemic circulation. Let's go into the topic. So actually this is the heart. Okay, so this in this heart, so this bluish color part is the deoxygenated blood and this reddish part is the oxygenated blood. So what happens priorly is this is the right atrium. So the right atrium will receive the blood from all over the body. So okay, from all over the body, superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Superior vena cava will bring the blood from head, neck and chest. Inferior vena cava will bring the blood from abdomen and lower extremity. So both the vena cava will bring the blood towards the right atrium. From here, the blood will go to, so the blood is actually deoxygenated blood or used blood or impure blood, whatever the thing. So from here, the blood will go to the right ventricle. So right ventricle through tricuspid wall. This wall we call it as tricuspid wall. And from here, for oxygenation purpose, the blood will go to the lungs through pulmonary artery. Always remind, whatever the blood vessel which takes the blood away from the heart, either it may be oxygenated blood or deoxygenated blood, then we call that as artery. So this is pulmonary artery. This is the only artery will carry the deoxygenated blood away from the heart. And from there, after oxygenation got completed, now the blood will go back to the heart, to the left atrium by pulmonary vein. So this we call it as pulmonary vein. This is the only vein which carry the oxygenated blood towards the heart. Remaining all the veins will carry the deoxygenated blood only. So this is actually the left atrium. So from here, the blood will goes to the left ventricle through bicuspid wall. We also call it as mitral valve also. Bicuspid valve or mitral valve. And next, from here, so this is actually the left ventricle. From here, the arch of aorta, so this is ascending aorta, arch of aorta, and descending aorta. Through this bigger aorta, the blood will go to the whole body. So the oxygenated blood will go to the whole body, so and supply to each and every organ. And this right side, whole right side, we have the deoxygenated blood. Whole left side, we have the oxygenated blood. So, and the blood circulation from lungs to heart and heart to lungs, this upper loop, we call it as pulmonary circulation. And heart to body and body to heart, this lower loop, we call this loop as systemic circulation. So we have two circulations. One is pulmonary circulation and other one is systemic circulation. Pulmonary circulation means from lungs to heart and heart to lungs. Systemic circulation means from heart to body and body to heart. So that's it. You got this point? What is pulmonary circulation and what is systemic circulation? Any doubts in this particular thing? Hello?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Are you clear with the circulation, right? How the blood will go here and there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what is heart? Heart is actually a muscular pump. So that heart consists of cardiac muscles. The cardiac muscle is striated involuntary muscle. And it could be, we also call it as an organ instead of a muscle. It beats on an average of 60 to 100 beats per minute, which is around 1 lakh times per day. So for each time when the heart contracts, the blood will come out of the heart. And when the heart relaxes, the blood will be filling the heart. So contraction, the blood will be pushed into the blood vessels. On relaxation, the heart will be filling the blood. And the heart is located in the mediastinum, towards the left side on the chest, that too behind the sternum. Sternum is actually the bone, and which is the size of the fist. So which will be shaped like a upside down pear, means upside down apple also, we can tell. The tip of the heart, we call it as apex. So it has three layers, endocardium, myocardium, and epicardium. Endocardium is the inner layer, endo means inside. Myocardium is the middle layer and muscular layer. And epicardium is the outer layer, so which has two layers again. One is visceral layer and other one is parietal layer. Pericardium. So heart was divided into three layers, endocardium, myocardium and epicardium. Outside this epicardium, we have the pericardium. So this is actually smooth, thin layer. This is the muscular layer. So this will reduce the friction when the blood, so the endocardium will comes in contact directly to the blood, and the myocardium is the muscle. This actually contraction to push the blood into the blood vessels. And epicardium is the outer layer which comes directly in contact with the pericardium. So in the pericardium we have the two layers. One is visceral pericardium and other one is parietal pericardium. So this is actually the heart. So this is endocardium. So endocardium only will comes in direct contact with the blood. And this is myocardium. So this is myocardium. And this is epicardium. And outside to this epicardium, we have a bag-like structure called pericardium. That pericardium also, we have two layers. Visceral pericardium and parietal pericardium. Okay. It may disconnect. I'll reconnect again now.